We want to represent the function f of x equals arctangent x as a power series, compute the first few coefficients of the power series, and then find the radius of convergence. But notice how in this case the given function does not resemble the formula used to find the infinite sum of a converging geometric series. But if we recognize that the integral of 1 divided by the quantity 1 plus x squared integrated with respect to x equals arctangent x plus c, we can use this integration formula to help us find the power series for f of x equals arctangent x. We'll try to find a power series for the integrand, and then we can write arctangent as the integral of a power series. But let's start with a more basic function first. We should recognize that if we have f of x equals 1 divided by the quantity, let's just say 1 plus x, we could write this as 1 divided by the quantity 1 minus negative x to better fit the form of the formula used to find the infinite sum of a converging geometric series. And therefore this function as a power series would be equal to the summation from n equals 0 to infinity of a, which would be 1, times r raised to the power of n. In this case, r would be negative x, so we have negative x raised to the power of n, and we can write this as the summation from n equals 0 to infinity of, well, negative x to the n would be equal to negative 1 to the nth times x to the nth. Now let's consider a function that more closely resembles the integrand function here. Let's let f of x equal 1 divided by the quantity 1 plus x squared. Well, using the power series for this function, we can simply substitute x squared for x in this power series here. So this would be equal to the summation from n equals 0 to infinity of, we still have negative 1 to the nth, but then we'd have x squared raised to the power of n, which we can also write as the summation from n equals 0 to infinity of, this would be negative 1 to the nth times x raised to the power of 2n. So now that we have a power series for the integrand of this integration formula here, we can now say that f of x, which equals arctangent x, would be equal to the integral of this power series integrated with respect to x plus c. Now if we integrate this power series, we can find the power series for arctangent x. So we'd have f of x equals, we'd have the summation from n equals 0 to infinity of negative 1 to the nth, and then we'll add 1 to the exponent of x, that would give us x raised to the power of 2n plus 1, and then we divide by the quantity 2n plus 1. And of course we still have plus c. Let's continue on the next slide. Notice how here, if we let x equal 0, we know arctangent 0 is equal to 0, and when x is 0, this would also be 0, and therefore c is also 0. So we can simplify this and just say that f of x equals arctangent x, which equals the summation from n equals 0 to infinity of negative 1 to the nth times x to the power of 2n plus 1 divided by the quantity 2n plus 1. And now we'll generate the first several terms to find the desired coefficients. If we go back to the first slide, notice how we want to find up to the degree 5 term so we can find c sub 5, which is the coefficient of the degree 5 term. So notice when n equals 0, notice when n equals 0, we'd have negative 1 to the 0, that's 1, times x to the first divided by 1. When n is 1, notice how the term would be negative, so we'll have minus x to the power of 2 times 1 plus 1, that's x to the third, divided by 3. When n is 2, notice how the term would be positive, so we'd have plus x to the power of 2 times 2 plus 1, that's x to the fifth, divided by 5. And of course this continues, but because we found the degree 5 term, we can stop. Let's go ahead and simplify this. We would have x minus, let's write this as 1 third x to the third plus 1 fifth x to the fifth, and so on. We need to be a little careful when identifying the coefficients. C sub 0 represents the coefficient of the degree 0 term, which would be the constant term. There is no constant term, so C sub 0 is 0. C sub 1 is the coefficient of the degree 1 term, the linear term, which is 1. There is no degree 2 term, so C sub 2 is equal to 0. C sub 3 would be equal to negative 1 third. C sub 4 would be equal to 0, since there's no degree 4 term, and C sub 5 would be equal to positive 1 fifth. Let's go ahead and record this on the previous slide. Again, we had 0, 1, negative 1 third. I assume this is a typo. This probably should be C sub 4, which was 0, and C sub 5 was 1 fifth. Now we still have to find the radius of convergence, where a geometric power series only converges when the absolute value of r is less than 1. So in our case, we would have the absolute value of x less than 1, and therefore the radius of convergence is 1. The interval of convergence would be the open interval from negative 1 to positive 1. And before we go, let's take a look at the graph of the divisional function and the graph of the polynomial function using the first three terms of our power series, which, because this is centered at 0, would be called the Maclaurin polynomial. So we have the original function graphed in blue, and we have the polynomial function graphed in red. And notice around the center of x equals 0, the red polynomial function is a very good representation of the original function graphed in blue. We should also notice that the center of the power series would be around x equals 0, and we can also recognize that the interval of convergence does look like it would be the open interval from negative 1 to positive 1. I hope you found this helpful.